Hey, what's up, gamers? Enforcer 5150 here, and if you're still crashing in Modern Warfare 2, I'm sorry, it sucks, and I am just as mad as you are in a lot of these cases, but I do have a few other things I did pick up that might help you out here. One thing I do want to mention, though, is that there was a party crash, and not the good kind. This is basically, if you were in a party, you would end up having some of the errors that we discussed in the last video. Well, Infinity Ward finally came back, and their developers said that they may have fixed it. They say, thank you for your patience. We'll be deploying a mitigation for party-related crashes tomorrow morning, PDT, and that was 8 hours ago, in which there should be out now. But the original tweet was, we're aware of some players experiencing crashes when partied up. Please stay tuned while we investigate the issue. Now, they have now, since about an hour ago, put this live. And they said, this update is now live. Players and parties should see significant improvement. Now, I don't like that word of improvement, because we were crashing. There's not an improvement from, you know, if you're crashing. This is something that, you know, needs to be fixed. I mean, if they say this should be fixed now, that would be a whole different thing, but they're saying improvement. So you may still end up having crashes while in party, and that is just ridiculous. Anyway, some of the other fixes that I wanted to go over was when you're crashing in lobby. Now, this may be with a party or without a party, but basically you want to try to switch lobbies, switch game modes, and see if that might stop the crashing. So you're going to end up crashing and have to get back in, but you're going to want to try to switch your lobby. But also, you want to unequip any animated calling cards or emblems. For some reason, that is having a lot of problems. Infinity Ward should be fixing this. It should be fixed already. I mean, it's day two already, and we're almost day three? Day two. Yeah, it's 29th. Ugh. Either way, it seems like forever because we've been trying to, you know, actually play the game and we haven't been able to, you know, just play straight on for a while now. But yeah, go ahead and try to unequip any of the animated calling cards and emblems, and that should fix some of the crash issues that you're having. Next, pretty simple, but try restarting your PC. I know this one seems very, you know, straightforward and duh, but a lot of people have been reporting on Reddit that basically just a simple restart has been fixing their issue. And mostly these are like temporary, like it'll like stop you from like repeatedly crashing. But when you restart, you come back and then you can actually play for like another hour and then boom, you crash again. Yay. No. But anyway, let's go on to the next one. You want to shut down conflicting applications. Now, this is kind of with the 1337 error that we're having. And it seems like it is more than just the audio drivers or audio software. There, I said software this time, not drivers. But a lot of it is the conflicting applications, and it has to do with IQ, Razer Synapse, Armory Crate, and even the G-Hub that you might have for Logitech. Pretty much any one of those applications can have one of these conflicts with the game, and it is causing, you know, a lot of issues. Now, IQ, now I don't know if this is 100% true or not, so take this with a super grain of salt, but some IQ users have been reporting that they have been getting banned for cheating because they have been running the IQ software. Now, it's plausible, but I don't think it's very possible, I guess I want to say. And, you know, some of these people may have been trying to cheat, and then they got banned while they're trying to, and they're trying to blame it on IQ. And that's my personal take on it. It may not be that, and I could be completely wrong, but I just say take it with a grain of salt. Anyway, another thing you might want to think about is disabling on-demand texture streaming. Now, this is something that Infinity Ward has been working with in the last few releases of Modern Warfare. Basically, they want to download everything as far as all your textures and stuff like that, put it into the memory. And anyway, when you have this going, it happens that it gets stored in your memory, and then sometimes you end up with memory leaks. And I know Cleston and Raven420 was having some problems, which I was pretty sure was memory leaks, and it might have been this. But this can fix some of your crashes and can also fix some performance issues if you're having them. Disable the texture streaming, see how it works out, you know, give it a test and all that. Hopefully, it should be all right. Now, next is, you know, let the game run in safe mode. You know, every time you load up, for some reason right now, it's every time I load up, no matter what. If I shut down the game correctly or not, it says, do you want to run in safe mode? Do you want to reset all your settings? No, I really don't. But it is a possibility that you might want to try to set these default settings, hit it in safe mode to see if some of the issues you are having is a result of some of the graphics that you're using. Anyway, it's a possibility that it can fix your issues. The other one is scan and repair your files. Obviously, we've already covered this. Let's go ahead, scan and repair your files if you're on Battle.net or if you're on Steam. Those are pretty self-explanatory. You already know how to do those. And if you don't, I'll put the instructions in the description below. Now, the last thing I want to bring up is disable antivirus and firewall. Those are very, very well-known issues that come up in almost any game. You always want to make sure that you're adding, you know, Call of Duty or any game that you have to your firewall to make sure that is allowed. I don't know which code it might give you for an error to be like, oh, this is what it is, but a lot of times, if you're having crashes and you cannot figure it out and you've been getting a certain error, you know, try disabling that firewall for a short period of time. I don't recommend keeping it off because, you know, obviously you don't want to leave your computer vulnerable. But, you know, it is a possibility that this will help the crashes that you're getting. Another thing is the Windows firewall, the built-in Windows firewall has always had problems with pretty much everything. So maybe you want to try a free antivirus that's out there that you can do third party instead of using the Windows Defender one. Anyway, yeah, that is all I have for this video. There's just so many different bugs that keep on coming out and different crashes, and I rather just keep playing the game than doing the videos, but I do want to share these things with everybody as they come in, you know, to my radar. So I don't want to leave everybody out because we all want to just play the damn game. Anyway, I want to thank everybody for watching this video today. Make sure you hit that like button and definitely subscribe if you're new to the channel. Y'all take care and happy gaming.